E is equals to mc square. Who doesn't know it? Everybody knows it. And everybody knows the genius scientist Albert Einstein. He said that everybody is a genius. But if you judge a fish by the ability to climb a tree, it will spend its whole life believing it is stupid. So everyone is different. Everyone is unique. Everyone has a particular ability, and that is why it is not good to judge people, and especially students, based on their academic qualifications only. So we have known Albert Einstein for all our lives. We knew him and always have seen him as an old man, the brilliant scientist, the man of a century, maybe centuries. But how was this man as a student? How was he when he was a young boy? Here is a depiction. Here is a presentation, a small biographical piece from his life when he was a young boy, a teenager studying in Munich. The chapter is Albert Einstein at School. Fourth chapter from Snapshots, written by Patrick Pringle, who was born in 1917 in London, United Kingdom. He has written books like Jolly Roger, The Story of the Great Age of Piracy, and he was nominated for Edgar Award for Best Fact Crime. Now, coming to the chapter itself, what is the theme? This biographical piece discusses the childhood of Albert Einstein, the famous physicist. The chapter starts with Einstein's disagreement on rote learning with his history teacher. Einstein wanted to get away from the system of education followed in Munich. So he decided to get a doctor's certificate, declaring that he has had a nervous breakdown and needs rest for 6 months. Only his maths teacher admired Einstein for his brilliance. But before Einstein could get an appointment with the head teacher to present the certificate, he was asked by the head teacher to leave the school due to poor conduct. So he felt happy on leaving. So Albert Einstein, in his teenage, was not at all happy with the studies, the way everything was going on as far as the education and the system was concerned. He was very unhappy in Munich, and he just wanted to get away from that God-forbidden school. And the chapter deals with that incident, that how he got away from that school that he disliked. The characters we have are, yes, we have Albert Einstein, the main character. During his school days at Munich, he was not interested in rote learning methods of school education and expressed his frank opinion. Nobody except his maths teacher recognized his genius. In the end, he was expelled by the school authorities. So somebody like Albert Einstein too was expelled from the school. Then we have Elsa. She was Einstein's cousin who advised him that he will eventually succeed if he continues in the school. Then we have Dr. Ernst Weil. He was newly qualified doctor who understands Einstein and helps him by giving the medical certificate which he required. We have Mr. Koch. He was Einstein's maths teacher who understood his genius and gave him the reference he wanted. We have the head teacher also. He happened to be the administrator who simply takes the disciplinary action required by requesting Einstein to leave the school immediately. Mr. Braun, his history teacher, who believed in rote learning system of education. And we have Yuri, who was Einstein's good friend and a very helpful person. Coming to the summary of the incident. Now, first, when you get started with the text, there is a dialogue going on between the history teacher and Albert Einstein. The narrative begins with Einstein being asked by his history teacher, Mr. Braun, about the year in which the Prussians defeated the French at Waterloo. Einstein frankly replied that he did not remember and he didn't see any point in learning dates. Mr. Braun was amazed that Einstein didn't believe in learning facts. According to Einstein, learning facts was not education at all. He thought that ideas were more important than facts. And as Einstein always said that education is not the learning of facts, but the training of mind to think, and the same thought he had when he was a young boy. It never changed. And obviously the teacher was very furious over his reaction, the way he was saying all this thing, and he did not remember anything. He did not complete his homework also. The teacher asked him to explain Einstein's theory of education, and Einstein shyly elaborated that he would be more interested in learning the reason why soldiers killed each other instead of learning years or dates, or which of the armies killed more men. After all, we can always look them up in the books. So the more important question is why the wars are there, why people kill each other. But the history teacher was not at all happy with this, and yes, Einstein got scolded. Mr. Braun was shocked and furious. He believed that Einstein had no desire to learn and was wasting his father's money. Mr. Braun did not agree at all with Einstein's views on education. He punished Einstein by asking him to stay for an extra period in school. He also told Einstein that he was a disgrace to the school and ought to be ashamed of himself. The teacher suggested Einstein to call his father to take him away. And Einstein was very disappointed and very sad on that day. He felt miserable. He wished his father would take him away. His father was not rich, so Einstein lived in one of the poorest areas of Munich. He hated the slum violence there. He was not worried about the dirt and the smell around, but he was more concerned about this slum violence. Munich is a city in Germany. He was there, and he lived in one of the poorest areas of Munich. And yes, he was bothered about the slum violence. Einstein had no comfort there. The atmosphere was bad, as his landlady beat her children regularly, and every Saturday her husband, a drunkard, beat her. The only comfort for Einstein was when he played his violin. But that was also stopped by his landlady because its sound disturbed her. All this made him miserable. There was no comfort in school. The education system was very bad there. It promoted rote learning, and when he went back to his rooms also, he wasn't happy there. So he actually was completely frustrated from everything around, and that is why he wanted escape. He just wanted to get away from Munich and that school. Einstein shared his pain with Yuri, his only friend in Munich. Yuri tried to convince by telling him that he was lucky to at least have his own room. Yuri also told Einstein that he was sharing a room with students who were not civilized at all, and they fought with each other. One of the students got killed the previous week in such a duel. The authorities did not take action and merely told them not to engage in such fights. Einstein got disgusted after hearing this account. So we can clearly see that this entire area in which these students were living was filled with violence. Even the students were fighting with each other, and nobody was taking any solid action. That again made Einstein pretty disturbed. Einstein was doubtful about passing his exams for the school diploma. He told Elsa, his cousin, the same when she next came to Munich. She used to visit Einstein occasionally, but she lived in Berlin, where her father had a business. Elsa tried to counsel him. She told him that she knew a lot of boys who were more stupid than him, and they had all passed the exam. She counseled him to continue his studies in the school. Einstein explained his helplessness by saying that he was no good at learning things by heart. He was reading a book on geology, which was not even a part of his diploma. Still, he was studying it because he liked it. Apart from books on science, his only comfort was playing his violin until his landlady asked him to stop. So Einstein was very much interested in other stuff other than only his books, his curriculum. He was more interested in geology. He wanted to play violin. He was interested in science and mathematics. But he had to learn and go through other subjects too. But main problem was the pattern in which they were taught. And Elsa also suggested that there are more stupid boys than you. All you have to do is learn everything, cram everything, and repeat it in the examination. There is no need to understand at all. And this is the point to which he could not agree. I mean, for learning, you have to understand everything. And the school system suggested that you have to just read and repeat. There was no point of understanding anything. And when he was completely frustrated of all the things, he decided to just get away from school. Einstein thought that it was meaningless for him to study on in Munich. It was no use wasting his father's money and everyone's time. Einstein suddenly got an idea. He met Yuri and asked him if he knew a doctor. Einstein wanted to get a medical certificate to show that he had a nervous breakdown and he should stop going to school. Yuri doubted that the doctor will believe Einstein. Einstein commented that he would have a real nervous breakdown to make matters easier for the doctor, because after all it was about a fake medical certificate, and if you go to the doctor stating that I am having a nervous breakdown, the doctor would immediately get it that you are not having a nervous breakdown. And that is when Albert suggested that, okay, I will go to the school regularly and attend all the classes, then the doctor will definitely believe me because I will look like a person with a nervous breakdown. Then Yuri found a recently qualified doctor, Dr. Ernst Weil. Yuri warned Einstein against trying to deceive Ernst, but to be frank and honest. Einstein met Dr. Ernst the next day. Dr. Ernst informed him that Yuri had told him about his troubles. Einstein informed him about his plans to move to Milan. Dr. Ernst gave him a medical certificate stating that Einstein was suffering from nervous breakdown and should stay away from school for 6 months. So his plan worked out and he finally succeeded. Einstein thanked the doctor and took Yuri for a meal. After all, Yuri told everything to the doctor and stated that my friend needs a medical certificate, kindly provide him one. And Dr. Weil also understood everything and gave him a medical certificate. But Einstein needed a reference so that when he goes to Milan, with the help of that reference, he could continue his studies and go to higher studies also. And that is when Einstein told Yuri that he would leave school forever as he never wanted to come back to that school. Yuri suggested him to take a reference letter from his maths teacher to Mr. Koch before going to the headmaster. Mr. Koch really admired Einstein for his brilliance and gave him the reference he said that you are better than any other student and I believe that you have learned everything that can be taught in the school as far as mathematics was concerned. He was very fond of Albert Einstein and he instantly gave his reference. And now Einstein had to go to the head teacher and submit that medical certificate. But he came to know that he was indeed being called by the head teacher. Before Einstein had a chance to give the medical certificate to the head teacher, he was summoned to the head teacher's office. The head teacher told him that he was expelled from the school and he should leave immediately. When Einstein wanted to know the reason, the head teacher told him that his presence disturbed the class so much that no teaching could be done. So Einstein was in the head teacher's room, who said, just get out of the school, you are expelled. When you are in the class, nothing can go on, nobody can study, nobody can teach, you do not complete your homework, you are in constant rebellion, you are such a nuisance in this entire school that we do not like a notorious student like you, just get out. And actually Einstein was pretty happy about it. Einstein felt happy to leave the school. When Einstein heard this, he felt sad that he had unnecessarily wasted time and effort in procuring a medical certificate. Einstein was tempted to tell the head teacher what he thought about the school or about the teachers, but somehow he stopped himself. But he did not feel ashamed of being expelled and walked out, keeping his head high. It actually happens to the teenagers, so he also was like quite happy that by this method or that method, at least I am out of the school. He did not say goodbye to any teacher or student inside the school. The only person he wanted to meet before leaving was Yuri, who wished him good luck and wished that he would be happier in Milan, as it was a wonderful place. So this brings closure to the incident, and we learned that how Albert, as a young boy, as a teenager, was fed up with the system, rote learning and all, and he wanted to just get away from that place and pursue his study in a right kind of manner, where science would have its place, where mathematics could have its place, and he finally succeeded too. And this brings us to the end of the session also. But before ending, I would like to mention that education is what remains after one has forgotten everything he learned in school. So education is not about books. It is not about notebooks. It is not about rote learning. It is something that can be found everywhere, from anywhere, from anyone, anytime. Education can be gained in the playground, in the recess, from a young fellow or an old fellow. It doesn't really matter. But yes, the chapter specifically talks on the theme that education is not about learning facts. It is about making the mind able enough to think, imagine. That is the pure purpose of education. One must be in a position to imagine things. So with this, let's close it for now. Understand the theme of the chapter, go through it again so that you can understand how Albert, right in the beginning of his life also, was more concerned about the proper way of gaining and attaining education. So thanks again for listening to me.